Dear students, CET 2013 allotment process allots seats for admission to medical, dental, Indian system of medicine and homeopathy, engineering, architectural and farm science courses. The allotment of seats will be done online by obtaining options from the eligible candidates in the order of rank in the CET 2013 based on the options given by them. Verification of documents will be done in at least 13 notified helpline centers across the state after declaration of merit list. Only upon verification of documents and issue of verification slip, the candidates will be allowed to enter their options. The entire process of allotment is controlled by sophisticated software and high-end computer, which examines minutely the options given by the candidates for allotment of the best possible seat to the candidate as per the rank and discipline which he or she is interested in. For example, a candidate is interested only in medical seat, then he or she will be shown the entire list of colleges for medical seat only. There are 38 medical colleges, and he or she can give all 38 options, but in the order of priority. The computer will decide the best seat available for allotment as per the rank and options of the candidate. If candidate is interested in only electronics branch of engineering, he or she can give preference for electronics only in all the engineering colleges. There are about 186 colleges. Computer will pick up option available as per merit and order of priority. In other words, the candidates are free to give options in as many colleges as they deem fit. The more number of options, the better it is for the candidate to secure seat of their choice. In case a candidate is eligible for both medical and engineering, and his or her best interest is in medical, then the candidate has to give as many options as possible for medical. Then, in the order of preference for medical should be more than other disciplines. The computer will then find the best option as per the rank and allot the seat to the candidate. Likewise, if the candidate is interested only in engineering, then he or she may skip entering choice for medical and concentrate only on engineering courses. The CET 2013 seat allotment process is executed in non-interactive online mode. The CET 2013 process consists of the following stages: announcement of ranks, verification of documents at helpline centers, option entry through online mode, allotment process, and admission process. Candidates will be allowed to enter their options only once. Candidates will be allowed to enter their options only once. Please note, the option entry will be allowed only once, which is before the first allotment session. The options entered by the candidates will be the basis for all further allotments unless there is an addition of colleges or courses. Therefore, candidates are advised to enter all possible options. In other words, candidates are advised to enter more number of options for all the disciplines to which they are eligible and interested, as there is no provision to add the options after the first allotment session. This is the home page of the option entry site for CET 2013. For the first time logging, you have to enter your CET number in the text box. Then, enter the text shown below correctly and click the Submit button. Now, enter the CET application number. The application number you need to enter is as printed on your CET application. You would have got a secret key number when your documents were verified at the helpline center. Please enter that key number. Now, you are going to create a password for logging into the site again. Please enter a password with a minimum of 8 characters, which should have alphabets and numbers. Re-enter your password in the Confirm Password box. The next box captures your mobile number, which may be used for SMS alerts. Provide your email ID, which is in use for email alerts. Choose a secret question from the list provided and provide the answer. This is done to recover the password that you forgot. Click Log In. To log in to the option entry website, you have to enter your CET number in this text box. Then enter the text shown below correctly and click the Submit button. Now enter your application number and secret key number. Enter your password. Click the Login button. You have now reached the online option entry main menu. On the top, you can see your name, CET number, and CET ranks in different disciplines to which you are eligible. To do the actual option entry, click on the candidate option entry link. You have reached the option entry page. Here, you can see three panels. The first panel is used for adding your options. The second panel can be used to modify the already selected options either by rearranging or deleting options. The third panel shows the options you have entered. Now, let's look at a model of option entry. A candidate by name Sachin has all the 12 CET ranks. Sachin decides that his first priority is engineering and decides to give an engineering option as his first option. So he clicks Engineering Bookmark in Option Entry Panel. Now all the engineering options are displayed in the Option Entry Panel. He can scroll across the various engineering options displayed college-wise. He chooses the option E154CE, that is Civil Engineering in Government Engineering College, Bangalore, as his first option by entering 1 in the box provided against the option and clicks on the Save and Submit button. You can see the option added message under the option entry panel, and the selected option is shown in the modified selected options panel and also under the selected options panel. Sachin now decides to give medical option. So he clicks on the medical bookmark and gives Bangalore Medical College as his second option and KIMS Bangalore as third option, and then decides to give fourth option as ISMNH, Government Ayurvedic College, Bangalore. Then he decides to give his fifth option in veterinary science and gives Veterinary College, Bangalore as his fifth option, and saves them all by clicking the Save and Submit button. Sachin wants to find the course code E001CE from the list of options. He clicks the search link. He enters E001CE and clicks on search button. E001CE option comes up and Sachin makes it option 6. After a while, Sachin feels like changing his options. So, he logs in with his CET number, application number, key number, and password. Option entry screen appears along with his entered options. He wants to make Veterinary College Bangalore, which is his fifth option, as his second option, and Bangalore Medical College as his fifth option. For this, he simply interchanges the priorities in the modified selected options panel by changing options under BMC as 5 and Veterinary College Bangalore as 2 and clicks the Update button. Now you can see that Sachin's options are interchanged. Sachin decides to remove his 6th option. To delete the option, he enters a 0 against the 6th option and clicks the Update button. Now you can see that his 6th option is removed from both the panels and the option has returned to the option entry panel. Finally, satisfied with his options, Sachin decides to take a printout of the option report. For that, he clicks on the option report printing link in the selected options panel. Sachin can take a report by either clicking the short or the detailed link. The short link is suitable if the number of options exceed 50 and the detailed version is suitable for few options. Sachin clicks on the detailed link. The detailed options report appears as a PDF document. He can print it or save it in his system. During allotment in the medical round, Sachin gets allotted a seat in KIMS Bangalore, which is his 3rd option. Later, in the engineering round, the system will consider the option 1 above 3 and allots the engineering seat in E154CE by leaving KIMS Bangalore. This happens because E154CE is an option above KIMS Bangalore. Now, we will learn about managing your account by changing the password, mobile number, or email and viewing the login history. Login to the option entry site. Click on the Change Password link under Account Settings. Enter your old password. Enter your new password. Confirm the new password. Click on the Change Password. you will see the message password changed successfully. Click on Back to Home. Now, we will find out how to see the list of colleges and courses available for option entry. On the right top corner of the page, click on the college list. For example, select Medical Counseling. You will be able to see the list of medical colleges. Click on Engineering link to view the list of engineering colleges and courses. Similarly, you can also visit the Agriculture BSc page. Go back to the Option Entry page. On the right-hand corner of the screen, click on the Course List link. Here, you can get a list of courses along with their descriptions. Now, we will learn how to use Option Worksheet. An Option Worksheet will help the candidate to be prepared with options. Log in to Option Entry menu. Click on the Option Worksheet. The Option Entry Worksheet appears. In the worksheet, the group indicates the discipline. E for Engineering, M for Medical, I for ISMH, and A for Architecture. The type indicates G for Government, A for Private Aided, B for Private Unaided, C for Deemed Universities, and M for Minority Institutions. College course code details are available from page number 79 to 96 in CET 2013 brochure. Now, your decision on the discipline, college and course in the order of priority, beginning with serial number 1, should be entered in the column option number. To work with these options offline and to make changes till you freeze on options, choose to print this sheet by clicking Print Report. KEA requests all candidates to go through this exercise without fail so that online option entry time can be optimized. In the detailed option worksheet, names of the colleges are also indicated. The CET 2013 allotment will be done after the completion of option entry stage. CET 2013 allotment is non-interactive, fast and optimized by providing the eligible candidates with the best of the best seat in the shortest possible time. It ensures earlier candidate satisfaction and facilitate a faster admission process. The non-interactive allotment process is the most optimized and easy process for allotment to professional degree courses. The process is fast and convenient for the candidates as it allows for participation from any location at ease with the help of an internet-enabled computer. This process also makes sure that a candidate with multiple ranks is allotted only a single seat, thereby providing opportunity for other participating candidates. Thus, the blocking of multiple seats by a single candidate is made impossible. The candidates need not participate in multiple physical rounds to get the full benefits of category conversion of seats. The benefits of seat category conversion is fully delivered to all candidates in the first session of allotment. The process guarantees the best of the best seat allotment as per the existing seat matrix in the first session itself. And the only benefit of participating in the further allotment sessions would be for the not admitted or surrendered seats after the first session. This will in turn lead to earlier candidate satisfaction and early admissions to college possible. The allotment process of CET 2013 performs allotment based on 12 different ranks. The ranks may be divided into three major categories. The CET ranks, that is Medical, ISMH, Engineering and Architecture ranks, the Farm Sciences ranks, that is Food Science rank, Agriculture, BSc rank, Veterinary Science rank, BTech Agriculture Engineering rank, and Agriculturists rank. One candidate can have one or more ranks, but only a single seat is allotted based on his or her options. There are 20 courses under 5 professional streams available under CET 2013. The courses coming under the medical stream, that is medical and dental courses, are allotted using the medical rank. The courses under the ISMH stream are allotted using the ISMH rank. The engineering courses are allotted using engineering ranks. The architecture course is allotted based on the NATA, NATA rank. And all the courses under the Farm Sciences stream are allotted based on 8 different Farm Sciences ranks. The allotment to Farm Science courses are introduced newly in CET 2013. And the allotment to these courses are done along with the CET 2013 allotment process. The allotment will be done based on 8 different Farm Science ranks. There will be separate Farm Science ranks under practical quota for agriculturist students who appeared for the practical examination. There are around 4,000 seats under the Farm Science stream. The Farm Science ranks and the respective courses are given in this table. The diagram gives an overview of the allotment process of CET 2013. The allotment process is done by high-end servers and sophisticated software, which carefully examines the options given by the candidates and allots seats as per his or her rank and the availability in seat matrix. The allotment is not an online process like option entry, and no interaction is required by the candidate. Karnataka Examinations Authority executes the allotment in a high security environment as an offline process. The results of allotment will be later published online, which initiates the admission process. The inputs to the allotment process are candidate details like reservation quotas, the different rank lists, the options collected through online option entry process, the opening seat matrix, the allotment roster, and the various rules for allotment. The allotment roster plays the key role in allotting seats under different categories. The roster defines in what order the various category seats have to be allotted to candidates under different categories. For example, a candidate will be first offered a general merit seat if available. Otherwise, he or she will be offered a seat in the respective reserved category if available. The major process in the allotment process is the allotment of seat to candidates. If a candidate gets reallotted to a higher option, it is called reallotment. Seat upgradation is the process where the category of an already allotted seat is upgraded to higher categories in the roster when such seats get released during allotment. For example, a candidate allotted with a seat under the reserved category is upgraded to a seat under general merit quota for the same course when the corresponding GM general merit seat is released during allotment. The round control will define how many rounds of allotments are required for the most optimized allotment. The inter-round seat conversion rules will define the seat conversions and their proper order of conversion between rounds. The primary output of the allotment process is the allotment itself. The allotment will be verified and published on web after the allotment process. The closing seat matrix will show the balance of seats after the allotment process. The allotment process will also provide various logs and reports like candidate allotment tracker, seat tracker, and seat matrix tracker, etc. The software also facilitates reports showing why a candidate did not get his or her higher options. A candidate who is allotted a seat in an allotment session can take admission through the admission process. The admission process consists of three compulsory steps: the payment of fees, getting the admission order, and reporting to the college. The payment of fees can be done either through online or offline modes. The online mode offers payment of admission fees using internet banking, credit card, or debit card. The candidates choosing the online mode can download and print the admission order immediately after the completion of payment. Candidates can also choose to pay by offline modes like Indian Bank counterpayment or CET counterpayment. The candidate choosing to pay through Indian Bank counterpayment can print the challan online in the website and proceed to any Indian Bank counters to complete the payment. The admission order will be ready for download one day after the Indian Bank counterpayment. Candidates may also choose to complete the process at any of the CET helpline centers. Candidates must report to their allotted colleges within the stipulated date by submitting the admission order. If a candidate is fully satisfied with the allotment and do not wish to participate in further allotment sessions, he or she should do the following: pay the fees and download admission order. Indicate not to participate further. Report to college. The implications of this choice are: the seat will not be returned to the seat matrix and will remain with the candidate. The candidate will be blocked from attending further allotment sessions. All options will be removed by the system automatically. If a candidate is satisfied with allotment but wishes to participate in next allotment session, he or she should do the following: pay the fees and download admission order. The implications are: the seat will not be returned to the seat matrix and will remain with the candidate. The candidate can participate in next allotment session. All options below the allotted option along with the allotted option will be removed. The provision for altering the order of above allotted options will be provided. The provision to add options of new college or course will also be provided, but no provision will be given to add any options that existed before allotment. By taking a decision to pay the fees and hold the seat without taking admission, the candidate expresses his or her willingness in joining the allotted college. If a better option is not allotted in further allotments, and the candidate becomes bound to take admission for that seat if he or she is not allotted a better seat in further allotments. If the candidate is not satisfied with the allotment but wishes to participate in next allotment session, then he or she need not do anything. The implications are the allotment will be cancelled and the seat will be returned to seat matrix. The candidate can participate in next allotment session. All options below the allotted option along with the allotted option will be removed. The provision for altering the order of above allotted options will be provided. The provision to add options of new college or course will also be provided, but no provision will be given to add any options that existed before allotment. If the candidate is not satisfied with allotment and do not wish to participate in further allotment sessions, that is, quit the CET 2013 allotment process, then he or she must indicate not participating further. The implications are the allotment will be cancelled and the seat will be returned to seat matrix. The candidate will be blocked from attending further allotment sessions. All options will be removed by the system automatically. Now, let's see what happens to a candidate who didn't get any allotment. All the options entered by the candidate will be retained as such. The provision for altering the order of entered options will be provided. The provision to add options of new college or course will also be provided, but no provision will be given to add any options that existed before allotment. Karnataka Examination Authority has strived all along to help candidates get into their stream they want to and the course in the college of their choice. With the non-interactive allotment process, KEA has taken another step forward to optimize use of time, money, and opportunity of students and parents to help every candidate to get the right opportunity and the best seat available in the shortest possible time. Karnataka Examination Authority, KEA, trusts that the non-interactive allotment process will improvise on the seat selection process and help candidate get the best of their choice with utmost transparency. Good luck, friends. Thank you.